Yeah. Nobody greater than God. I don't care where you look. I don't care where you go. I don't care what you do. I've been at Memorial since Tuesday morning, y'all. And I just know that there's nobody greater than God. I know the doctors do a lot, but if it's not for God, y'all, the doctor can't do a thing. And today, I came to this house to praise God.
Amen.
I've been in a waiting room, I've been in the ICU, and I just see people sitting around. And y'all, I bless God because God has given me a peace. Just a peace, because I know that God is not going to make a mistake, and I know that His will be done.
Oh,
so for those of you that are praying for Mother, I thank God for that. But last night, y'all, I got an opportunity to minister to somebody that was going through what I was going through. I said, God, I think I'm growing a little bit. If I can minister through some stuff that I'm going through to somebody else, I feel good. I was proud of myself, y'all, because I was hurt. And I could see her hurt, and I just felt God just pushing me. At first, you know, when we feel God pushing us, we want to sit still. But when God pushes you and tells you to go do something, you got something to do, you better get up and go do it.
Amen.
Christina's going to come with our scripture right now.
Amen.
Y'all give her a hand.
Mark chapter 10, verse 13 to 16. And they brought young children to him, that he should touch them. And his disciples rebuked those that brought them. But when Jesus saw it, he was much displeased. And he said unto them, suffer the little children to come unto me,
yes,
and forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of God. Verily I say unto you, whosoever shall not receive the kingdom of God as a little child, he shall not enter therein. And he took them up in his arms and put his hands upon them and blessed them.
Amen.
Thank you.
you ever had a stormy day in your life?
Come on,
what about a broken heart? Anybody ever had a broken heart? If you can witness to any of those things, we got some things to say. If you hadn't been through those situations, you wouldn't know God like you do. Amen?
Amen.
Those situations allowed us to get closer to God. Put your hands together. Let's pray God like this.
Thank you.
Thank you.
way, you just have to live. You're ready. So we're going to continue to give God praise. I want y'all to give a hand for Brother Noah Cooper. He's going to introduce our speaker.
Amen.
Time in the high security prison, God began to work in his life. Brother Godchild had a friend of his grandmother. In the prison cell on April 18, 1998, Brother Godchild had an encounter with God that will change the course of his life and destiny forever. He's here today to share his testimony with us. Please welcome our guest, Brother Godchild.
Amen. right.
Thank you.